Surrender your kingdom or face my wrath. Never. Then it is settled.
Lovely day today, isn't it, Thomas?
It certainly is, sir.
Sir, there's a radio report. It's the news. It seems very important. You should hear this.
Amazing news here today from the Copley Hill radio station. It can be reported that Adolf Hitler is at last dead. This will likely bring about the end of World War II and peace amongst the world.
Wow, this is amazing. Let's celebrate, everyone. George, play us your finest rendition of...
Hey, ponies, listen to me. You gotta hear what I'm saying. cameo.
Everyone, if I may be so bold, what with the Holocaust ending and everything, I believe the summer of 1945 will be the best summer in Sudrian history.
Don't you know that's a surefire way to make sure everything gets more ridiculous?
Don't worry, everyone. I will find the person who did this and hold them responsible. Sir Topham Hatt climbed aboard Birdie, and off they went in search of the mysterious thief of the statue. What's going on, Birdie? Why are you slowing down?
Sir, there's some cows on the line.
Oh, not today. Today of all days. Hello, sir. Hello, Thomas. Oh, well, you see, that wasn't just any old statue. That was a statue of King Merin.
King Merin?
Yes. You see, many, many years ago, long before there were locomotives on the island of Sodor, there were two kings. As you know, this island is divided in half by an enormous mountain. And there was a king on each half of the island. There was King Merin, and there was King Godred. And the two kingdoms were always at war. Eventually, King Merin and King Godred fought, and Merin was killed.
Oh, so that's why that park is called Merin Park. It all makes sense now.
That's right, and apparently several thousand years is not enough time for some people to get over a tragedy. So you see how stealing that statue was sort of a significant political statement of sorts? Anyways, I think it's all a bunch of nonsense, but I'm hoping the summer can still get back on track. I think this all blow over in a couple days, and then we'll still have a great summer. Bye, Thomas. And for the second consecutive time, Sir Topham Hatt was very, very wrong.
Day off.
Sir Topham Hatt was in the middle of an important meeting with Rudolf Diesel, the inventor of the diesel engine. Mr. Diesel was attempting to sell more of his diesel engines to Sir Topham Hatt, but Sir Topham Hatt was being very stubborn on the matter. Sir Topham Hatt prefers to keep Sodor predominantly steam. He understands that diesel is, in many ways, superior to steam, but Sir Topham Hatt is a very nostalgic man. When he was a little boy in London, he lived next to a large train station and constantly watched the big steam engines puff in and out day and night. It was then and there that at the age of 8, Bertram Hatt decided what he wanted to do with his life. And 40 years later, here he was, living the dream.
Mr. Diesel was beginning to grow very impatient with Sir Topham Hatt.
Sir, you must understand, the diesel engine is revolutionary. Switch to all diesels and you'll double your profits in a week. I understand you want to keep Soto a heritage railway primarily, but you have to cut corners somewhere.
Now, Mr. Diesel, I have purchased several of your diesels in the past, and they do work well, but the steam engine has been good to me. I've had steam engines all my life. I just see no reason to update.
Modernization! That is the reason to update. Steam is out of date. Within 50 years, there will not be a single steam engine left on the rails.
Isn't there anyone on this blasted island who would buy one of my engines? What about Mr. Percival? He has enough engines. Caldifel?
What about that, Duke and Duchess of Boxford who come in from time to time? What about them?
The Duke and Duchess of Boxford live in London but spend their summers on Sodor. They have a private steam engine named Spencer and they use my railway for transportation to their summer house. If you want to try and sell them a diesel, it's fine by me. I don't control them, but you're not going to get a diesel from me.
Fine. Good day to you, sir.
Mr. Diesel was on his way to catch a train that was ironically to be pulled by a steam engine when suddenly there echoed an enormous noise. Soon after, a coal truck shot out of the tunnel, but it was no ordinary coal truck. It was on fire. The coal inside it had completely ignited into a raging inferno. Quickly, some workmen took notice and dialed the fire department. In a flash, Flynn arrived on the scene, along with the rest of the fire department, to put out the blaze.
You just had to say it, didn't you?
Nothing, just a shining example of the competence of your railway. A burning coal truck shot out of that tunnel and stopped right in the middle of the main line. Oh, and look at that. There's an illegally parked fuel cart right in the middle of the line. If the points had been set differently, there could have been an explosion. Well, never mind the fuel car. Where did the coal car come from? Said it was on fire? It came right out of that tunnel. Bet it was retaliation for the shooting yesterday. I'm going to get to the bottom of this. And with that, Sir Topham had gotten his car and raced off to Scarlowy. All right, Percival, explain yourself.
Oh, hello, sir. I wasn't expecting you.
Cut the chatter. Just shut up. Why did you send a coal car over to my railway that was on fire?
What are you talking? I didn't send any coal car.
Oh, don't even pretend like you don't know what I'm talking about.
I'm not pretending. I don't know what you're talking about. I didn't do anything.
Oh, you don't know? You don't know, huh?
Yes, I don't know.
Yeah, right. I'm gonna get you back for this.
Back for what?
Oh, you'll see.
Idiot.
Wait.
Yeah, they said the repairs would cost more than what the car was worth, so I just bought a new one. Well, here it is. Wow, isn't she a beauty? Rusty the diesel engine works in the quarry on the Scarlowy Railway. He is in charge of moving trucks around and keeping sure that everything is kept running. He is the only diesel on Mr. Percival's railway. But he doesn't care. He loves all his steam engine friends, and he knows as well as they do that it doesn't matter the source of traction as long as you're really useful. Rusty's most common job, other than moving slate cars, is to work in the transfer yards. This is a place where the Scarlowy Railway and the Northwestern Railway meet, connected by a tunnel. Here, by use of a crane, the two railways are able to exchange goods directly.
Diesel, perfect.
Yes, sir?
I have an important job for you.
What is it, sir? I'll do anything.
I need an engine for an extremely important task. Ah, Thomas, perfect. There's the engine I wanted to see. My favorite engine, right there, Thomas. Thomas, I know you must be exquisitely busy, but I have a most important job for you today, and not any engine will do.
It's okay, sir.
I'd almost forgotten. Diesel.
Yes, sir?
Well, Thomas is doing that job now, so you can never mind that, but I still do need an engine to pull his coaches for him. So, why don't you go find an engine to pull Thomas's coaches?
Couldn't I just do it?
Don't be silly. Well, gentlemen, let's begin.
Rusty was parked on a siding, eagerly awaiting new work. Suddenly, the sound of a slam followed by a whoosh echoed through the tunnel. The truck, full of coal, was on fire, and it was spreading quickly. Luckily, there were workmen nearby, and one of them telephoned the fire department. In a moment, Flynn was on the scene. Flynn is a special type of vehicle that can travel on both road and rails.
Sir, I need to get through.
I'm terribly sorry, Flynn. It seems there's been an atrocious accident here. You'll have to take the long way.
All right, sir.
What's wrong, Flynn?
Oh no, my cannons are out of water.
Well, what are we gonna do? Everyone, Flynn needs water.
Just then, in the midst of the pandemonium, Rusty noticed something. He saw Peter Sam coming down the line. Suddenly, Rusty had a thought.
Everyone, he called. Peter Sam, stop. We must use the water from Peter Sam's tank to extinguish the fire.
Rusty, that's genius.
And so quickly it was done. The water flowed from Flynn's cannons once more, and soon the fire was extinguished. But the damage had already been done. Many thousands of dollars worth of coal had been lost.
What on earth has happened here?
Oh, sir, there was a terrible fire, but Rusty, with his quick thinking, saved the day. He's a true hero.
But where did the fire come from?
Oh, there was a burning coal car that shot through the tunnel.
You mean like the one that happened at the Northwestern Railway yesterday? The one that Sir John Pat thought was me?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Bill and Ben are tank engine twins. They are always together. And they are always causing trouble. Together, the two of them work at the Farquhar Quarry Company.
They have two colt ponies that worked with them that were small enough to fit inside their cabs. And they, of course, were Snips and Snails. The two engines each have...
Are we clear on the plan?
Could you go over it again, sir?
Like I said, we go into the signal box and we ask them for the train schedules for today.
Well, why are we wearing disguises?
Are you daft? I don't want to be spotted.
I think you're still recognizable, even with the big mustache, sir. What did you two do now? You two were always causing trouble.
It wasn't me. It was Bill. What are you talking about? It was Ben.
I don't care who started it, but I'm finishing it.
Well, what am I supposed to do? I was supposed to be up at the quarry mine 5 minutes ago. Now I can't go at all.
I'll cover for you.
Fine. There you are. I need you to take that stone car and shunt it into the other siding, please.
Suddenly, Bill was stuck on the edge of the cliff.
Were too far over the edge to pull himself back in, try as he might. The portion of the rails that protruded over the edge were beginning to bend under Bill's immense weight. As the rails began to curve downwards, Bill's weight shifted further towards the edge. Mavis and the workmen could only sit back helplessly and watch.
It wasn't your fault, Ben. It was just a freak mistake. You didn't cause it. You didn't mean for it to happen. It was just an accident.
Day on Sodor. The Duke and Duchess of Boxford were about to arrive for the summer. Their private engine, Spencer, had already arrived on the island. Sir Topham Hatt knew well the advantages of having the Duke and Duchess on his island. The two of them were extraordinarily wealthy, and they used his railway exclusively for transport.
He and the Duke and Duchess had developed quite a friendship. It was, in Sir Topham Hatt's own words, an extraordinarily financially advantageous acquaintanceship. Thomas was puffing down his branch line. All of a sudden, he saw Spencer coming the other way and quickly applied his brakes. Stopped so suddenly that he derailed, and Spencer roared past him.
Ah, there we go. All according to plan. Now we hide and wait.
Luckily, no one was hurt. Duke and Duchess were very confused.
Oh dear, what's happened here? Terrible tragedy, I'm sure. But you know how unreliable those steam engines are, always breaking down and collapsing. You folks deserve yourselves one of the new diesel engines. They're much more reliable. I have heard that they're better.
In fact, I happen to sell them. Would you be interested in purchasing one? So, while Spencer was being taken to the Sodor Steamworks, Rudolph Diesel managed to make a sale. What's this? The Duke and Duchess? The line? Down? By the Scarlowe?
Ugh, it must have been Mr. Percival. I've had enough of him. You know what? Contact my financial advisor. I want to cut off all systems of trade with Mr. Percival. I will no longer do business with a rat like him.
Wait, what?
Why the hell would you do that?
Pause this right now! Pause! Fucking hell! Pause!